This is the weather forecast video for Tuesday, March 20th, 2012. Let's take a look at the satellite image from last evening. You see a storm system in the middle part of the country producing some showers and thunderstorms, some with severe weather and some with heavy rainfall, and that'll be slowly moving through the area the rest of this coming week. Watch warning map from before midnight shows numerous severe thunderstorm and tornado watches from Missouri south and westward, along with some flash flood watches and warnings and some winter weather issues over the northwest and in New Mexico. The QPF chart precipitation over the next 5 days through Saturday evening at 7 o'clock shows some decent amounts of rain across the state of about 1 to 2 inches, while heavier off to our south and southeast. Here's the 0Z GFS Model Run at 1 p.m. this afternoon. You can see there's that upper level feature becoming cut off from the main flow over Texas and Oklahoma, and still the showers and thunderstorms along and east of it from Iowa, Missouri, Kansas, southward into East Texas and Louisiana. Some storms could be strong, especially south of here. And it continues into Wednesday as that upper level feature just slowly moves through Oklahoma, so shower and thunderstorm activity continues about 20 to 30%. It increases slightly on Thursday as the low begins to slowly move this way, about 30% chance of some showers and storms. And while this is going on, temperatures will be down into the 60s to near 70 for highs. Friday the storm moves into Missouri, and there still could be a chance of a shower or storm, about 20 to 40% chance, with highs still in the 60s to lower 70s. And by the weekend, the storm is finally pushing off into the Ohio Valley. Could be an early morning shower Saturday, otherwise it'll be clearing, and finally the sun will come back out full time, with temperatures even by Sunday back into the 70s. So this warm weather just doesn't end, and it's still going to stay above average even for the weekend with dry conditions, especially on Sunday. Monday, another storm begins to take shape over the plains. Could bring some shower and thunderstorm activity, especially over the Siouxland and up into Minnesota. By Tuesday, a week from today, there's that storm moving through the Dakotas and Minnesota with the energy on with that. And there could be some shower and thunderstorm activity then across the rest of the state. Possibly some severe weather. A little too early to determine that at this time. We'll have to wait and see on future runs. Several days later, on April 2nd, the ridge is back over the eastern part of the country with a trough over the east coast, another over the Rockies and westward, with some energy off to our west that could bring some showers and thunderstorms into western and central Iowa at that time. So we'll have to see how that turns out to begin the month of April. And at the end of the forecast on April 4th, ridge is back over the eastern part of the country, a trough pretty broad over the Pacific Northwest. And that means the temperatures are still going to stay at or above average. High pressure over the southeast. Gulf will be open, so there could be some shower and thunderstorm activity with that storm as well. We'll have to wait. Thank you for tuning in to the weather forecast video. We'll have another one on Wednesday.